Given Monday's announcement of the gravitational wave detection of a pair of colliding neutron stars, I thought it might be fitting to tackle a topic that lies on the absolute fringes of the search for extraterrestrial communications. As with any form of SETI, this one has advantages and disadvantages depending on your point of view and the circumstances of your civilization. But it does remain within the realm of the possible, if not the practical. It is communication through gravitational waves. Gravitational waves propagate at the speed of light, just like electromagnetic waves such as radio signals. But there's a difference. EM signals can be blocked, delayed, scattered, and so on, meaning that they're good for close-in communications, even within an entire galaxy, but not much further. Gravitational waves are not subject to this, meaning that very, very long-distance communication could be accomplished. They'll even pass through a solid object, like a planet or a galaxy. But this would be an unbelievably expensive form of communication. Essentially, a civilization would need to be routinely slamming black holes into each other to orchestrate some kind of signal, and then hope that the civilization receiving it has sensitive enough equipment to pick it up. Our own equipment has only recently become sensitive enough to pick up gravitational waves at all, and even then, we only did it through truly hypersensitive detectors looking at some of the greatest possible gravitational disturbances present in the universe. So why spend the energy doing this? Say you have a true Kardashev Type 3 civilization. You control the energy of an entire galaxy. In this case, slamming black holes together might not be out of the question for you, and your civilization may be so advanced that you have little else to do other than maintain your society and attempt to contact others on an intergalactic scale. There may in fact be a specific reason to do this. We all know about the Fermi paradox. The galaxy has been around long enough for a Type 3 civilization to have arisen and colonized the entirety of the Milky Way. In such a circumstance, we should see evidence of this civilization literally everywhere. And I'm not talking small things like alien ships stopping by to say hello, but rather the galaxy itself should be so dramatically altered by that civilization that nothing should look natural. We don't see that. We just see perfectly natural appearing objects when we look out into space. This works for other galaxies too. Searches for Type 3 civilizations that have dramatically altered their galaxies, such as most of the stars being encased in Dyson shells, have not yielded a single galaxy that doesn't look perfectly natural. Granted, distance here is an issue. The further you look out at galaxies, the further in the past they appear. So eventually, you reach a point where there simply hasn't been enough time elapsed for a civilization to arise from your viewpoint. This lack of visibility could mean a lot of things. But one thing it could mean is that the solution to the Fermi paradox is that intelligence is extraordinarily rare in the universe, and even then may not be able to develop into a civilization, meaning that only a handful of technologically advanced civilizations exist in the entire universe. In such a state of affairs, a Type 3 civilization may choose to use gravitational waves as a repeating pulsed beacon, perhaps orchestrating the collisions of neutron stars or black holes, specifically because it may be the best method of communication over intergalactic distances. Will we someday hear a heartbeat of gravitational waves coming in at unnatural regularity? I think it's a stretch. I merely mention it as food for thought. But in the end, gravity still propagates at the speed of light, so any such civilization would have to wait millions or billions of years for a response, if it ever comes at all. But in a universe that could be habitable one way or another for trillions of years, it would seem that such a civilization would have nothing but time on its hands. Thanks for listening. I am science fiction author and futurist John Michael Godier, currently plugging my second channel. In what was not exactly an earth-shaking stroke of creativity, I named it John Michael Godier 2, and on it I discuss science fiction, both my own and that of others. I haven't posted there much over the last few months, but I'm about to start back up, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.